Hi guys, it's still raining. I'm making another video. These are a couple books. I'm in the middle of this one. I read this one first. These are by the same author, Tim Young. And after I read this one, it made me want to know what his story was. So this is his actual first book. And this one is How to Make Money Homesteading So You Can Enjoy this a Secure, Self-Sufficient Life. Okay? And it's got 18 inspirational real-life profiles. This is a very good writer. It's a well-put-together book. And it might give you some ideas. I found that the ideas presented were kind of, already out there, so to speak. So I didn't find anything too new here. But it's well-written, and I was intrigued enough. I wanted to find out more about this author because he had written their story. And this couple, he and his wife, they were in the rat race. They had big jobs. They lived in the city. They didn't really have a rural background, but they sold everything and they weren't happy, and they bought some bare land and started homesteading. And I'm only halfway through this, but what I was hoping to find out is how they did that financially, and as an average person. But as I'm reading this, he wasn't an average person, at least not in my mind. He is an entrepreneur up the wazoo. He's very bright. You can tell by the way he writes. And by the time he was in his mid-20s, he had risen up the corporate ladder and was a vice president of something, I don't know. And then later on, he was able to start his own business and go from one employee himself to 450 in just a short span of years. So this guy had a lot of success behind him, a lot of financial success behind him. And they had a nice house in suburbs and the whole nine yards. So he was able to sell that and have a really nice nest egg, I'm sure, to start his farm. And what I'm not all the way through the book, but I'm waiting to find out, did he sell his company? Or is he getting residual paychecks or money from that to fund his farming? Or is he doing all farming? I don't know yet. But this is my frustration, because I find this with YouTube channels too. They'll tell you how they saved up and scrimped and got out of debt to buy their property. What nobody talks about is how do you do the monthly stuff? Because if you own property, you have property taxes, for one thing. You have insurance costs. You have fuel for a vehicle. Even if you are Amish, you're going to have hay for your horses. You know? What about dental stuff and medical stuff? If you're not off-grid, you're going to have utility bills. I mean, and not everything that you need or use can you make or produce yourself. And everybody talks about salt being the obvious thing. But so how do you buy that stuff? If you quit your day jobs or quit your rat race jobs and you get out in the country, how do you make ends meet on a month-to-month basis if you're debt-free? And tools break. I mean, repairs to stuff. I mean, there's just so many things I can think of that cost you money that you may not be able to handle yourself, that you do need to pay someone else to do. So that's my question. If let's turn this around and scare you off. If you've shucked it all and moved out in the country and you're homesteading and not kept your day jobs or your town jobs, so to speak, how are you doing it? How are you making ends meet? I think that would be really helpful to people to know, because that to me has been the thing that has not been answered anywhere that I've looked so far. Why am I researching this? Because, I don't know, I'm 53 years old. I'm thinking I might have another 10, 12 years in my job. And then I would hope I could think about retiring or at least going part-time. But the other thing is, I have to pass my CAT scan boards in January or by January in order to keep my job. And if that doesn't happen, I might be unemployed. Who knows? So I'm looking at my homestead trying to think of what income streams could I create and generate here. I really don't have time right now, but if I'm not working, I'll have time. And how much can I expect from that? And is it doable? You know, my husband and I refer to our situation as being in the golden handcuffs, because we both have good jobs that we couldn't duplicate at our ages anywhere else,
And there's little things like, because he doesn't have to buy insurance, I buy it through my work. His employer's so happy that he subsidizes my husband for whatever I pay in insurance. So basically we get free insurance. Now, we couldn't duplicate that anywhere. So there's all these little things that make it so hard to think about, what if we didn't have our jobs? I mean, I would love to be home full-time. Don't get me wrong. I would love to make money off this property. I just can't quite figure out how. The conclusion I'm coming to, though, is instead of having, like, one big thing, you know, one big crop or one big venture that generates most of your money, you need a bunch of little small income streams. That's what I'm coming up with. So you have to be quite organized. And a lot of times they're tied in with seasons and whatnot. But anyway, if you've done this, if you've gotten your property, gotten out there, quit your day jobs, and are still making ends meet every month, I would love for you to comment down here in this comment, or put up a, better yet, put up a video yourself, and we'll link it somewhere. And I don't mean if, I don't want to say you don't count, but if you are retired and you're getting Social Security, or if you're on disability check, something like that, you know, not everybody can do that at the stage of life they're in. So that really wouldn't be a viable option for me anyway, right now. So if you're getting some kind of pension or retirement funding and or some kind of public assistance, I want to know how people are generating their own income beyond those avenues. So not knocking them, I'm just saying for the average person, you know, if you're 20-something with a young family, you're not probably going to get Social Security. I'm not 20-something, but you know what I mean. Okay, so I'm going to put that out there and see what comes up in the comments. Bye, YouTube.